Alrighty, welcome to my first Kamigawa Neon Dynasty draft. What do we got? Rare-wise, Soul Transfer is a good start. Basically, it's 3-mana exile any creature or planeswalker. It's already great. Or you can return a creature or planeswalker from a graveyard. And if you have an artifact or enchantment, which is kind of the black-white theme, as you can see with like the Pillar of Order here, you get both. So really high floor. Like the worst case scenario is a 3-mana removal spell with a high ceiling where it can get a nice 2-for-1. So pretty sure I'm going to take that. And Voltage Surge is maybe one of the best commons, or it is one of the best commons, maybe close to being the best. And I'll keep a Reckoner Raid. I love it, the aesthetic there, the rat biker gang. All right, I'm going to take Soul Transfer, though. I think that one's fairly easy. Ooh, I like Leech Gauntlet a lot. 2-2 lifelink for 2. It trades off early, and then you can equip it late and get a lot of value. Hossman with the 85 months, the record holder. Thanks for hanging out. And Joria, well, thanks for gifting some subs. I appreciate that. Appreciate everyone hanging out. And Fatsmaster with the 16 month. All right, what else do we got? We have Patchwork Automaton, which is pretty good. It grows whenever you cast an artifact. But just because we have Soul Transfer doesn't mean we're necessarily that. Kumano Faces Kakazan is a 1-mana 2-2. With some other abilities, which isn't bad, but I think I'm just going to take Leech Gauntlet. It's an artifact for this. It's also really good just in general, and yeah, I think it's a pretty easy pick here. Just staying in black is also good. Okay, so Heiko Yamazaki is very good. So 3-3 Trampler for 4, but when you attack with a Samurai Warrior alone, you can cast artifact from your graveyard. So imagine trade off Leech Gauntlet. Bam, play Heiko. That's good. There's also Circuit Mender, which is pretty hard to turn down. 3-mana, 2-3, gain 2, plus draw a card is basically exactly where I want to be. So I am pretty happy with that as well. Virus Beetle's fine. Inkrai's Infiltrator is really good in the Ninja deck, but that's not where we're at right now. Hey, what's up, Sponzy? So I think Psycho's better, but I think I'd rather just take a colorless card here. I have 2 black cards. I mean, Moon Circuit Hacker is also pretty good, but I think I'd rather just take a colorless card and keep my second color open. Okay. What do we got here? An Okiba Reckoner Raid. This is an enchantment. And it makes an enchantment creature, if I care about that. There's Moonsnare Specialist, which is, this card's busted. I mean, 4-mana, 2-2, bounce any creature is very good, and you can ninja it in and get more value. Artifact creature, this one's fine. Pure Subduer's fine. I think I'm just going to take the Moonsnare Specialist. Getting one fourth pick is definitely a signal, and like, it's just such a good card. I don't know. Hey, Old School Crusader with the 10-month resub. Welcome back. Hey, Mariah, I'm glad you enjoyed the Penny Arcade stream. That was a lot of fun. I think Okiba Reckoner Raid is awesome. I think this card's really good, but I still think Moonsnare Specialist is better, so I'd rather take that. Oh, yeah, the Enormous Energy Blade has to be holding it like this, too. But anyways, Moon Circuit Hacker is very good. 2-mana, 2-1 looter, but you can ninja it in for just 1 mana and start and draw a card. It doesn't loot when you ninja it in, it just draws. It's also a 3-1 or a 3-2 lifelinker. Kind of nice that this is an enchantment for this. That's a sub theme, really. Taking a black card is a little better than taking a blue card because I'm a little more firmly into black, but I really do think that if I take this, I could end up in kind of a nice little ninja deck. This is actually sneakily good for ninjas because you attack with this 2-3 into their like 3-2. If they trade, you draw a card, so they let it through, you ninja it, then you gain 2 more life when you play it. I think, I'm just going to take the Ambusher still. I think this card's still better. I don't know, that's close. I'm not sure. Scarlet Storm with the 33 months. Welcome back. Mirror Shell Crab is kind of cool, because you can pay 3-mana, make it a, and it's a counterspell for 3, like a mana leak. But then later it's just a 5-7. Reality Heist is good if you're like, it's a dig through time if you're super into artifacts. I'm not there yet. I like Searchlight Companion as a 3-mana 1-1 flyer for ninja options. I have 2 ninjas so far and it's a little artifact. I like the Shadowwalker too, but I feel like I would rather err on the side of having more enablers and fewer ninjas than too many ninjas and too few enablers. So I think I'm just going to take Searchlight Companion. Mobilizer Mech, I'm not super high on. 3-4 flying crew 3 is just not that good. You have to have other vehicles in order for this to really be good. So I might go the terrarium, because you go get a basic and then it's an artifact that just kind of sits in play and then you can later sack it to give a counter. Hey, what up, Falco Shine? I could also just take one of these white cards, like Repel the Vile, maybe. Hey, what's up, Gabby? It's also Bearer of Memory. I don't care about cutting the blue card. It just doesn't matter. I think I'm just going to take Repel the Vile. Just a fine card. Oh, I do like Dockside Chef. Sacking an artifact to draw a card is pretty good. It's a 1-mana 1/2. It's like decent dish with ninjas. I think rather than take a double blue card, I'll just take this black card. Plus, it's an enchantment. Oh, wow. So, what was that Dockside Chef? That the restaurant noise is funny. So this wield, but there is another ambusher. Wait, this isn't wheel. This is pack 8. So actually, I could get another one after this. Whenever it enters the battlefield or attacks, you have an artifact and an enchantment. I feel like I'm good, pretty good on that. Let's just take that. I don't see a reason not to. Okay. Because white also did look open. A tap land that is any color, an enchantment that gives -1/-1, can't block. This is not really where I want to be, because I don't not going to be that aggressive. But it is a cheap enchantment. But I have a couple enchantments already. Oh, I guess with the ninja out. No, I guess I only just have the one enchantment right now. I'm just going to take the land. Fixing's good. So this is a modified, but it's not artifact or enchantment. Not really that where I want to be. There's also this, the network terminal. I'll take network terminal. I don't think I'm going to play any of these cards, though. I still don't really want Imperial Subduer or Planner Incision. I guess I'll take the Dramatist's Puppet. Oh, wow. Well, the White Shrine is an enchantment. All right. Take the White Shrine. Take just the white card. So I'm not really feeling like I'm necessarily playing white or blue. I have two white cards. I guess 3 white cards. Repel the Vile is fine. 3 white cards and a blue card. But I've got 4.5 black cards, and the black cards are better, so... Okay, this is really good in blue-white. Maybe we're splashing. There's another Mokhtai Ambusher. Runaway Trash Bot. This is the white saga that's gain 2, scry 2, and then gets a 2-2 first strike. This is the first draft of the set for me, yeah. There's a couple random blue cards. Maybe I take... I have the Uncharted Haven. I got the Network Terminal. So I have a couple fixers. And this card is pretty strong. Gets cheap artifacts or enchantments back from your graveyard and draws you cards. I guess I'm just going to take the Reality Architect and see where we go. Could take a rest. It's not bad. There's also a black-white land. There's also a cheap black artifact. So I think... I don't think I want Tinker. We don't really even need to be in black. Three of our best black cards, our cards are black. So I don't think ditching black is a very good idea. I might just take the arrest and just kind of see where we end up. Maybe, I don't know what we're splashing quite yet. It's the best place to be. Oh, okay. So there's Ninja's Kunai. So this is the cheap equip that you have to have a creature is the biggest cost, but this nugs for 3. Oh, yeah. The Beetle's awesome, obviously, Ryan. There's just, like, the getting to play a cheap artifact that has a little activation thing. Yeah, I mean, I could take that. The Ninja's Kunai to go with Tameshi. Hey, what's up, Mediocre at Best? Welcome. There's kind of mediocre black cards. Tranquil Cove is nice. I think I might just go Tranquil Cove here. Oh, you're still not Ryan Sachs. I don't know why. You have like the same name as his Twitter name. That just confuses me every time. I don't really care about that. Armguard Familiar. Oh, I kind of like Sky Swimmer Koi. 4-mana, 3-3 flying, and then it loots whenever an artifact comes into play. This is not bad. I don't think I need that. I don't think I need that. Not aggressive enough for Befriend the Moths. I think this guy, Summer Koi, is just great. So what I'm looking to do here is probably play black, like just Esper colors. And I have three fixing things already, and we'll see where we end up. Hey, what's up, Rebecca? I don't think I'm in ninjas, but Moonsnare Specialist and Muktai Ambusher are just good cards to cast. I don't think you're too sad about casting them. I did pass a bunch of ninja stuff pack one as well. Well, there's ninja. another shrine? No, I don't think I'm doing that. I could definitely see just taking Moon Circuit Hacker and being blue-black, splashing a couple white cards. Temeshi does work with ninjas, y'all. All right, I'll take this. It's also just a good two-drop, which is nice. No, we're not doing Walking Skyscraper. I don't think we're doing Dragonfly Suit or Roadside Reliquary. I think just another Uncharted Haven. Look, if we're trying to play three colors, you got to have some lands that let you do that. Okay, this gets back a ninja or a rogue. It's a 5-mana 3/3. Hey, Georgia, thanks for gifting a sub. So right now I've got a ninja. And I've got a wizard moonfolk now. And this is a ninja. And that's a citizen. So I've got three ninjas to get back. That's probably worth specking on. The Mind Rot seems fine too, yeah, for sure. Oh, another Searchlight Companion. There's also Kami of Terrible Secrets. If you have an enchantment and an artifact, you draw a card and gain a life, which is pretty nice. I've got a couple enchantments and a bunch of artifacts. Yeah, let's take Kami over Searchlight Companion number two. I think this actually could be a deck where Kami's good. Oh, another Ambusher and a Mnemonic Sphere. Oh, it doesn't work with ninjas. I see. This is non-creature. Sure. Let's just take another Ambusher. And, oh, there we go. The Virus Beetle. Cheap artifact, good to ninja. Just a good little value play. Don't think we're mech hangering. I don't think I'm going to Chain Flail Centipede either. But I don't think I'm playing any of those blue cards. I don't think I'm playing any of this stuff. Okay. So going into pack three, I have an Arrest. Well, I'm not playing either of those, I don't think. And a Pillar of Order. And the activation on Temeshi, but I'm blue-black otherwise. Oh, another Ambusher. It's also Return to Action. I think I'll just take another Ambusher. One of the things that ninjas kind of cost you when you return is they cost you a little bit of board presence. Because you spend, let's say ambush a ninja this in. I spend 2 mana and bounce like a 3-mana card. So I kind of paid 5 mana for this. But gaining 3 life off this buys you a lot of extra time. So it's actually a really good combo, lifelink plus ninja. Though I kind of now wish I took the second Searchlight Companion over to Kami of Terrible Secrets. So I do think this is pretty solid. I have a ton of artifacts and like 1, 2, 3. Oh, look, the Mind Rot came back. Sure. Okay. I'm not taking the land, but ooh, Behold the Unspeakable. I like this one. Gives their whole squad -2/-0, and then next turn you either draw 2, scry 2, or draw 4, and then you get like a 3/3 flying trample or something. It's also Prosperous Thief, which I think is good, but I want to take Behold the Unspeakable. It's also Lethal Exploit, which is solid. Crab is solid, but Behold the Unspeakable looks quite good. More Enormous Energy Blades, huh? There's also Twisted Embrace. Pretty hard to turn this down. It's a removal spell. You have to have a creature to play it on. But I feel like I will often enough have one. And so I'm going to take that. So right now I'm at 24 cards, but I have 3 lands. So kind of like 21 cards. And I've got some cards I can cut for sure. Network Terminal is probably a card. Teach me how to play. I've gone 2-3 with 2 garbage decks. I will do my best. Okay. So here I've got phase out X creatures. Not really in for that. 5-mana 3/4 flyer. When you non-token artifact enters the battlefield, you can pay 2 to make a token that's a copy and you keep it. Oh yeah, I'm in for that. I like the Scrounger as well. This one actually looks pretty good, but I think that the Replication Specialist looks quite strong. And maybe I just cut this 5-drop instead. Is it a long draft stream or an enormous stream? I guess we'll have to see. 3/4 flyers are pretty nice too. Yeah, like look at, isn't Leech Gauntlet still one of my best cards? 2-mana 2/2 lifelink that has value later and like, I don't know, just does a lot of good stuff for you. This format looks pretty fun. So I am in for this. Okay, what do we have here? Futurist operative, another commie of terrible secrets. So this is a really funny card. It's when it's attacking, it's just, oh, I'm a normal citizen. No suspicion here. All of a sudden you untap and it's a 3/4 or it ninjas. But not really where I want to be. I think I'm just going to take Mooncircuit Hacker. Another cheap creature, another enchantment. I don't know. Dockside Chef is a one drop for two Mooncircuit Hackers. I mean, that's like pretty decent. Oh, ninjas and rogues get +1/+1. Nice. It also makes ninjas cheaper, but that's not a big deal. But yeah, I mean, I'll take that. I think I like the ninjas kunai, but I've got to take Silver Fur Master here. So I'm like artifact ninjas. Maybe I just cut the white cards at this point and don't need to do all that. Like, seems like what I could do is I could play the two Havens and the Tranquil Cove for the activation on Temeshi or something. Another Mooncircuit Hacker, but I think at this point I probably should take Lethal Exploit as just -2/-2. There's also Ninja's Kunai might actually be better because it's so good with this. And it's an artifact. I can loot it with, let's take the Kunai. I don't actually know if that's going to end up being better, but I kind of like this. Another Futurist Operative, Klong Torment. Another decent enchantment to bring back. There's also Sunblade Samurai. I could splash that as a white card. I don't think this is where I want to be because playing this and then ninjaing off this is, it's a lot of mana. So maybe I just play Sunblade, take Sunblade Samurai. Oh, wow. That's a cheap Reckoner Raid. All right, I'm going to take Reckoner Raid. This card seems very good. Another Virus Beetle there, but Reckoner Raid looks awesome. Ooh, the Brute Suit. It's the Brute Suit Riot. I mean, I have a decent amount of ways to do that. There's also Uncharted Haven, which I don't think the fourth tap land is where I want to be. I guess I'll take the Brute Suit. I guess I'm probably not going to end up playing that. Sure, I'll take the Enormous Energy Blade. Why not? Taking cheap artifact. Do I think three-color decks have more support this set than in the last two sets? Yes, by a lot. There's just the cycle of common duels plus the Uncharted Haven means that like, you end up with being able to splash a lot more often. Ancestral Katana, I think, is good. I'm not going to play it in my deck, but oh, wow. Ninja's Kunai came back. I guess I would have wished I took the other one now. Okay. I like the little monkey noises. That's good. All right, what do we got? So this is 41, splashing off the samurai because it's also an enchantment. I mean, at that point, maybe I do splash like this thing. It's pretty strong if you're doing both the things, right? Hey, don't stop Santa with the 76 months. Welcome back. Welcome back. Because I'm not really looking to cut too much. I guess, I mean, even the Mind Rot seems kind of good with all these ninjas. Colony of Terrible Secrets. How many enchantments do I have? Enchantment 7 and 9 artifacts. Yeah, the Kami looks good. That does make me want to get this in as well. Yes, this can fix you. That's why I'm playing it for sure. I kind of like everything that's going on here. Maybe I just have to cut the Kaito's Pursuit. I think you're going to end up in the spot a lot where you just things that aren't artifacts or enchantments in a deck that like cares about having both. You just kind of have to make some trims. No, we're going to play one planes. I just haven't fixed the mana yet. I'm deciding if I want to play 16 lands because I have a land cycler and a lot of cheap cards, but I probably shouldn't do that. When can we expect your grades in the untapped app? Well, I have to finish all the set reviews. I have 4 of the 5 colors done, and then it's kind of, I'm not sure what their timeline is. I'm kind of into everything here. Maybe I just cut the Sunblade Samurai instead, or I could potentially cut Virus Beetle because it doesn't really get through very easily, but it's an artifact that just does a lot of stuff for me. Maybe I just can't play two of these, but I have a lot of creatures, right? 18 creatures right now? Yeah, so I'm not going to lack for creatures on this. What's my initial impression for best colors? I don't know yet. How does Uncharted Haven compare to Evolving Wilds? Better, I think, generally, because you don't have to play a mountain in your deck in your blue-black deck when you want to splash red. You could just play two of these or something. I guess I could just cut a Muktai Ambusher. Painful, but yeah. All right, and then I want to cut a Plains also. So I want to play one Plains and six Islands or something. Yeah. So we're going to go with... Mm-hmm. We're still going to go with the Sweet Lands, obviously. Okay, so I have 9 black sources, 9 blue sources, and 4 white sources. Look at that perfect mana. 5 white sources if you count Samurai. So, all right. Let's see how this goes. Ooh, wait, why did my deck have 4 colors in it? Do I have something in there that's off color? Hey, Corrine, 17 months. Welcome back. Isn't playing 41 cards okay? No, it is not. You should not do that. Oh, yeah, look at this hand. Turn on Reckoner Aid. I mean, the land being tapped actually could be unfortunate here, but still, turn on Reckoner Aid, turn to one of these. It's a pretty good start. This is going to be the card that when their opponent plays on turn one, you're gonna be like, really? Gabby. This is a positive stream only. A chill positive stream. Azus has many journeys. You can play an additional land this turn and gain 3 life, and then you get a thing. Cool, cool. This is going to turn flip. It's not going to have haste. I might just play the Silver Fur Master here. Because I would rather ninja this in and just draw the card, I think. Hey, thanks for the Reed Raid. Welcome, Reed. We're chilling here. Mech Titan Core. So they need to exile this and 4 other artifact creatures or vehicles to make a 10-10 with 70 abilities. How'd the drafts go today, Reed? I hope they went well. Oh, nice. Searchlight Companion's a nice one. Let's go Searchlight Companion. And then next turn, I've got the ability to do some good ninjaing. So I'm pretty into that. See what they've got. All right, they get their 3/3, then if I block it, they untap 3 lands. Okay, well, it's pretty easy. I just won't block it. Suppose that's that. Okay. And this one's pretty weak, right? Yeah, 2/2 that gets +1/+0. So I guess it's an artifact for that thing. So they need 4 other artifact creatures or vehicles, so they've got 2. Okay, I mean, that's actually getting kind of scary. Like, we do have to kind of worry about that. This has reach, yes. So now, can I attack? I attack with a 3/3 menace. They can block with those two. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, I guess it's probably worth attacking with a 3/3 menace because I'm trading off for something better. And then if they don't block, obviously I'm happy with that too. They've got a block. I've got a Silver Fur Master in play. Obviously I'm ninjas. Oh, okay, they're going to double block. Sure, that's fine. Either way, I'm going to get something here. They probably should block with the Likeness of the Seeker, actually. Yep. Okay, now I'm just casting this thing as a 4/3. I mean, Silver Fur Master's doing good work, even if I'm not actually getting any ninjas through or anything like that. I think that's pretty decent. Okay. Let's just attack with the Ambusher. I'll just keep playing Ambushers. At some point, you know, like, what are they going to... They're going to activate a Brute Suit and block? Sure. I'm happy to trade off for really any artifact creatures they have, because that makes it less likely they can use the Mech Titan. Oh, really? They're going to let me ninja. All right. Okay. Hold on. I want to hold on control, because I want to put this in. I'm going to do a fancy play. So this, and then spend one to ninja this back, because this is cheaper. So I've already gotten the damage trigger off here. And then I get to, yeah, I'll take action. I'll draw a card. Sounds good. Mm-hmm. Buy a chicken, sell a chicken. Yeah, that is what we're doing. And then I would play this. This actually worked out pretty nicely. Hey, thanks, Dofbrof, for the gifted sub. And put it on this. It's just tap sack, right? Oh, one tap sack. So I should play this on tap land. All right. So now I get to throw the kunai at the Bamboo Groove Archer end of turn. Yeah, you can do a lot of ninja tricks. So basically, I wanted the damage trigger from the hacker, but then I wanted this in play because this is a bigger, better attacker, and it leaves this in play for multiple uses. Silver Fur Master actually did some good work with that. Made it cheaper to activate ninjutsu. Mm-hmm. Okay, sure. I'll let the Brute Suit hit me. See what they got. Oh, this can nug their face too? Jeez, that card is pretty good. Okay. They can't currently crew anything. So we're indeclare blockers. Okay, so let's put this. And let's just return this thing. Enough tricks. Just take a million damage and I gain a million life. All right, they are donezo. Nice, nice. Nice little round one dub. All right, let's play again. Sweet. That worked out. All right, I'm on the play. Oh, look at this. Turn one Chef, turn two Moon Circuit Hacker. And we have Soul Transfer, one of our better cards. Deece. Monkey Wiz, welcome to the divination. Okay. Well, mine's a 1/2, so. I mean, I might be getting re-ninja'd here, but I'll take it. This is such a good value play that I'm not scared at all. I mean, and then next turn, I guess this is 3 mana next turn if I want to play, use it, do all, like, all the things, but that's not too bad at all. Mm-hmm. The new board does actually look like Runeterra's board. This is true. I have to discard a card? Let's just discard my most expensive card, I think. Because I have there's a good chance Soul Transfer will get that back for me. Hmm. I'm not going to trade Moon Circuit Hacker for Virus Beetle. And because this costs one to play, one to equip, and one to use, I can't use it quite yet. So let's do this. I'm going to name black because I have a double black card, and then I will hit them for one. Wow, Gravelighter's not bad to discard. Okay, so they can... let's see what they ninja in here. Seems like they're going to do something. A bounce. The bounce ninja's not even good. You bounce this, that's not good. Bounce this, it costs one mana. Bounce this, might be better in my hand. So, pretty happy with the state of affairs here. If they put in the 3-2 lifelink, that's fine. Oh, that's pretty good. So the 3-2 that makes a treasure when it hits me. Sure. Okay, Ambusher's kind of nice, sure. So right now, attacking with this doesn't seem good. They have two blockers, so playing and using this doesn't seem great. I will attack with these two, I think. If they double block here, my Beetle gets through and I get to ninja it. Oh, well. Let's ninja the Beetle because that's just better value. And then I can just play this. If I didn't have this to play, I might have bounced the Chef because I could replay the Chef. But this seems like a better place to start. And then I have a 3-2 to block that. They do get to get a treasure out of this, unfortunately. Are Mind Rot effects going to be a good strategy? I'm not sure. Mind Rot's... it's really hard to tell how good a Mind Rot's going to be by just looking at the cards. Once I've played like five drafts, I'll have a better sense. This is two games in. I just don't know yet. Because it's kind of subtle as to why when Mind Rots are going to be good. You can't always just get the sense of it right away. This is my very first draft. This card's really good. Network Disruptor is definitely one of the best blue commons for sure. So yeah, so Sponzy, ninjas make Mind Rots more appealing because your opponent ends up with cards in hand in the middle of the game more often. But it also, it's kind of tough to like ninja, to Mind Rot them after they play a ninja if you don't have the board kind of taken care of. All right, so they get their treasure and a draw card. Haboss with the 5-month resub and Excel is Twilight. 17 months, welcome back. Thanks for joining us. I mean, at some point, I'm probably going to Ninja Star their Network Disruptor, if anything. Oh, sure, that's a 3-4 blocker. That's pretty good. Mm-hmm. Okay. Two cards. I don't need to play the Virus Beetle yet. At some point, I would like to draw a land. I can also Soul Transfer. I have both artifacts and enchantments here. Who would I kill, though? The funny thing is I guess I would just kill the Futurist Operative. And I guess given that, I could then attack with this. That's probably good enough. Happy to trade for whatever it is they want to trade for. Sure. And then I have blockers back for Moon Circuit Hacker. They're not getting value out of this hitting every turn now, which is nice. I do need to draw lands, but I'm up kind of a lot of cards, right? They have 10 cards. Well, I guess we're actually even on cards, but I haven't played my Beetle yet. And like all my cards would provide extra value. So I guess we both Beetled and Moon Circuit Hackered. I'll just block with the Moon Circuit Hacker. I don't think it's that likely it gets through, and the Dockside Chef has a pretty nice ability as the game goes on. Sure, they get to draw a card. They were getting a card either way. All right, there we go. Now I'm just going to play the Sky Swimmer Koi. No reason to play Koi here. Though I did literally play a Koi. But and then next turn, if I draw a land, I'll play Replication Specialist and start going off with these. If I don't, I'll probably... put the ninja's kunai on something and then maybe play like one of these two. Both these beetles, these both look kind of like, I guess this is a spider more. These are both strong, yes. I mean, I did exactly what I said about this card. I played it. They discarded it. I attacked and bounced it to Ninja. Like, it was good. Their Beetle's also done a good job of keeping me back and being a 2-for-1. Okay. Sure. They hit me for 4 now. How strong do I feel being on the play in this set is? I don't know. It's probably fine. So this is black. I don't need too much blue. Let's name white. I don't mind getting hit for another 4 damage here. Not leaving up the Kanai. I guess maybe one reason to play the Beetle is because it lets me activate this. So maybe that's better. Mm-hmm. Despite having Replication Specialist in hand, I did feel like I needed to play one of my artifacts this turn. Okay, this worked out nicely, because now I can play this, pass the turn, and now I get a double discard next turn at the very least. Ninjas are way better on the play. Yeah, ninjas are typically better on the play. That's true. Okay. You're just not going to block. If they ninja something, I can skewer it. And I don't care about taking a little damage here. I don't want this to die to the, like, the -2/-2, which I guess would be a -3/-3 right now, but still not. Oh, geez. Okay. Well, if they have red mana, that card's really dangerous. Okay, I'm glad I named white. I guess I'll still just play this. Mm-hmm. Okay, now that they didn't... Now I probably have to block with Replication Specialist is my guess. I don't think I could take 4 again. I wanted to give myself a turn to see if I could get some good value. I think I'm gonna block this. Mm-hmm. And if they have the -3/-3, then they would have to do it before damage or after damage, so they still lose their creature. I don't really like losing this if that's what's going to happen, but yeah, that's the card I was worried about. I don't know. I just don't feel like I could just take damage again there. Oh, that's interesting. I'm at 7. Let's nug this thing. Oh, nice. Draw a card and gain a life. I guess they only have one card in hand, but I should just make them discard it anyway. I didn't want to use the Kunai because I didn't want... Oh, that's not bad. I don't have the Replicator in anyway. Oh, Silver Fur Master. So they did have a Ninja. So I can attack with the Pillar of Order and trade for Guardians of Aboro. 8. Cash this in for a card at some point. Alright. Let's just do this, because I get another Samurai. I think that's fine. No, wrong order. Alright. And then next turn, I'm probably just going to attack with everything, and then Dockside Chef, whatever the Hidetsugo blocks. Okay, so I discard a card, sure. Oh, I could sack a creature instead. Yeah, I guess I'll sacrifice a Virus Beetle. Mm-hmm. I'll take 8. Or take 2. I'm at 6, sure. I could attack with the Kami of Terrible Secrets. I don't think so. I don't know. I restarted untapped and did what I believe I need to, so. Sack Circuit Mender. It's probably not the one they wanted to block, because that's the one I wanted to sack the most. They can sack the Beetle to Scry for 2. The white-black theme is controlling an enchantment and an artifact, something like this, which I've managed to do in, I guess, I'm blue-black splash-white. I'm a little worried about them having a red mana, because this card's sick if I have red mana, but two bottom. All right, well, I like the sound of that. Oh, I like the sound of that too. I'm at six. They're at 11. Yeah, I'm actually still gonna do this. I'm at seven now. Also, the Searchlight Companion's a flyer. So don't mind that. 2/1 that if it leaves battlefield, you can pay two to draw a card, sure. Okay. Don't think I want to attack with Dockside Chef here. And so they're going to get a big menace attacker, but it's not going to be able to attack right away. It doesn't have haste. Let's play this. Sack this. All right, play land and pass, and then I'm gonna probably block the Gravelighter and then sack it. Is my plan here? So this is gonna be a 7/4 when it attacks. I mean, I don't think it doesn't look like it's gonna come to that, but we'll see. My turn. No, I don't think I need to sack anything in a turn here. Because I need to make sure I have enough left to block this. Okay. I think I'm just gonna pass. I don't think I need to sack anything right now because I want to have enough blockers to block, and I can just block and sack this. If you bounce the saga, they just get the saga back. Okay. I might just do this, actually. In fact, I will not be sacrificing. I'll just let those things trade off. Dockside Chef, from turn 1 to turn 10, did a lot this game. Okay. Let's just take my turn. Oh. And Nugged. Okay, nice. This is draft number 1. We're ranking up. Hey, you gotta start somewhere. Yeah, the Kunai is great. I think the Kunai is just a good card. I mean, this deck has a bunch of synergies with it, which makes it better, but I think it is just a strong card. Yes, making the chef throw the knife would have been more appropriate, but it's not as good of a play, I don't believe. Yeah, this looks fine. I'm probably going to go black on Haven, turn 2, cycle this, channel this for a Plains. I guess I could play the Silver Fur Master. Make a 1/3 that taps for artifact mana. Shua. No, let's just pass. Because I'd rather make sure I hit my land drop on 3, because I can play this and then maybe do some ninjaing. I'm not sure. Ooh. They're ramping. Reckoner Bankbuster. So this is a 4/4 vehicle. If it draws 3 cards, you get a pilot and a treasure. Sure. Just play this. Gonna need to pressure them, because this card is a... This card is going to get them some decent value. Would I play a Kappa Tech Record, a Ninja Turtle, and a blue-black ninja deck? I don't know what the Tech Record is. Is that the 1/3 Death Touch? Probably not. That's not a very splashable card. You got past Soul Chance for Hosman? That's the place to be. I had to first pick mine. This activates abilities too? Yeah. Ooh, look at that. You can crew this and then crew something else. Sure. I would like to draw a land, though. Would be nice. Mm-hmm. As things stand, if I don't hit a land, I guess I'm just, like, going to ninja in. Oh man, I can't even engine both. I would be able to if I had the right colors, but let's see what they do. But I just have five drop, four drop in hand. So I really would like to be able to deploy things a little better, especially since they're drawing extra cards and the combination of those cards can be kind of brutal. Okay, swamp is excellent. So now crew three, right? Okay. Do I even want a ninja this turn? I don't even think I do. I think I just want to play the koi. Because then I can play this and loot and try to find more lands. So. Mm-hmm. Hey, what up, Gross Spiral? So they can attack for 7 here? Sure. Also double block. I kind of like doing that. If they have a trick, you know, or a removal spell, so be it. But I get to crack. I have a good turn on my next turn if they do. Okay, nice. That took away a lot of their value. Because, like, that was getting value because they would draw cards, and it would eventually make a pilot of treasure, and the mobilizer mech was giving them value. Oh, wow. Two mobilizer mechs. A real Mecha Godzilla. So currently I don't have any enchantments, unfortunately. But I could maybe get some value off this thing. What did they do? Oh. So they drew a card and put a +1/+1 counter on this. Sure. Oh, they could have ambushed me. Huh. Because they could have, this came back as a 3/3. They could have crewed a mech. All right, so I'm going to get bashed for 6 in the air. Oh, no, not even really, because I can just block one with a 3/4 flyer if I want to. I am potentially not going to get to ninja soon, but at some point I could just cast this and make a copy of it. Just end up with a bunch of Mokutai ambushers. Also, if they don't play another card out of their hand, I'm going to get their last two cards. Or they're going to counterspell my Virus Beetle. That also works. So far, I haven't been punished for playing three colors. Okay, they counterspelled my Beetle. Sure. I can start getting stuff back too. What do you think of this format so far? I'm 3 games in. No, we're still far from the format judgment. Okay, so they can scry with this because they can tap it to crew their vehicles. They have no cards in hand. Feels like I'm just gonna win pretty easily here, but we'll see. Really? No cards in hand. All right. I mean, Temeshi is going to get some real value here. So I can't get through, so I'm not like ninjaing or anything. I mean, I don't even need to Temeshi here. I think I just do this. This is a rat ninja, and then I replicate it, and then next turn I play silver for a master and attack with a bunch of 4/3 lifelinks. They get their scry one. Bam. Left card on top. They have two value engines to deal with. Whoa! They get to Nug for 4. Okay, they killed one of my value engines. This is not an artifact, so I cannot bring it back with Temeshi, but still. So that's a 3/4. So I could trade for that. I'm not like loving that idea. I have no cards in hand. Getting back the Beetle doesn't do much. I could get back the Samurai. I mean, that doesn't sound too bad. Could also get back the Searchlight Companion. Maybe that's even better. Mm. Let's get back Searchlight Companion. This triggers when a non-creature is bounced, but... Oh, there you go. That's pretty nice. I guess I don't have an enchantment yet, do I? I'm just going to cast this. I think that's fine. Samurai does get back... Does get me these things on, so I'm probably going to do that at some point here. Mm-hmm. So this is a 5/5 menace. Okay, that's fine. I can do some blocks. Yeah, the Oroshi, the Moonfolk, the Mirrorfolk that bounced lands to do things. This is a throwback to that. They're crewing on upkeep, so they get additional scry. Makes sense. One thing that's a little annoying about this is bouncing a land when you're drawing cards and bringing stuff back is like not really where you want to be, because you want to hit a land drop every turn, and this kind of makes it so you don't do that. But I'm not too worried about that. I will survive. Also, if they get too aggressive attacking, my 4/3 lifelinks are going to come knocking on their door. Okay. I guess now is when they're doing that. Yeah, there's a fair amount of fixing. There's a Uncharted Haven, which is kind of like Evolving Wilds. And then there's 10 duels that gain one ETB tapped. Ooh, they have a Biting Palm Ninja. Sure. They get to take my soul transfer. It's fine. It doesn't really matter very much. And I gain 8 life off that exchange. What's better, Uncharted Haven or Evolving Wilds? Uncharted Haven, I think, is probably better overall. But it's close. It depends what's going on. It depends on the deck. In this deck, Uncharted Haven's definitely better because I'm only playing one Plains. And I think that getting to name whatever I want off this is good. But the thinning off of Evolving Wilds is like a little reasonable as well. I don't know. Okay, so I have a 1/2 flyer. I guess I don't really care too much about ninjaing because I don't really have a ninja. If I attack with a 4/3, that's just a good attack, right? Yeah. And they're... And then I think I just bring back the samurai. I could bring back the ambusher, but I want an enchantment in play, so let's just do that. Yeah, see, now I have like a bunch of lands in my hand, so I'm probably not going to activate this for like a turn or two, but I'll be back there soon enough. So yeah, I mean, they kind of need to keep this thing back to block that. They can hit me for in the air. I guess if they pump, they're hitting me for 6 and 7 in the air with the Puzzle Maker. Sure. Tentacle Monster with 18 months. Welcome back. If they ever pass with a card in hand, I can also eat it with the Virus Beetle. Oh, there we go. That with the Reality Architect is actually just sick. So, let's see. Let's do this first. Get my token. Play this and name white in case I want to do this multiple times to turn. Play this. And I guess just pass the turn. I don't really want to trade for Circuit Mender until a turn where I make bigger attacks because it gives them a card. Actually, what I need to do is next turn I trade for Circuit Mender and then put a Virus Beetle in play. Is Naomi actually good? Yes, this card, I've cast it twice. Both times it's given me a Samurai, and then we'll get another one when I attack or whatever. They kept a card on top. Well, they have a lot of things that... like, at the very minimum, they need to kill Tomeshi. Otherwise, like, the game's basically not winnable. And even if they do, they're now behind on board. I've drawn so many extra cards. Oh, I don't actually think this board state's less complicated than you might think. They're just losing really badly. Yeah, why would this fly? She got on top of that building the honest way. I'm at 16. Yeah, I'll take it. They bricked on Reality Heist. There we go, huh? I mean, they're just super dead here. I was going to nug the Circuit Mender and just attack with everything, and that was just going to be good enough. All right. Start at the bottom, and now we're here, very close to the bottom still. Yeah, I've liked how the cards I've played. It's funny, this deck starts out kind of looking like a ninja deck, but then it's actually just a three-color control deck with a lot of late-game engines. But I like late-game engines. I already like this format more than Crimson Vow. I know it's too early to make a judgment, but just the interactions that we're seeing are like things that were sorely lacking in Crimson Vow. So I'm liking that. I'm on the play. Okay. When's the last time hand destruction was meaningful in a format? Every format, it's meaningful. It can be better or worse, but I don't really understand what hand destruction being meaningful means. Like, there's some discard cards that are good and some that are bad, but like, the format's like not about that exactly, you know? Oh, okay, there we go. So let's play this and name white. This card's cool. Vroom. Mind Rot is playable in every format, but, well, playable to sideboardable in every format. I mean, I'm not currently playing Mind Rot, right, in my deck. Circuit Mender is a particularly good blocker here. If they kill it, I draw a card. If they don't kill it, I attack and I bounce. Then they draw a card when it leaves the battlefield. This is one of the ones that would be better if it wasn't a creature. Like, they got an extra damage in because it was a creature here, but it's less vulnerable when it's not a creature. It's very good either way. This is a constructed level card to me. Looks better. In constructed, it's better it being a creature, of course. How many Moonsnare Specialists? Too many? Not really a number. This card gets better in multiples. It is weird that we're playing games and all their stuff is in the lake here, but that's how it is. You should be main decking Artifact and Enchantment. Well, yeah, you definitely should. I'm not sure about the one mana, like, Lucky Offering, kill a three cost or less one. Oh, Ninja's Kunai. You gonna kill my Circuit Mender? I can live with that. Oh, nice. That's the enchantment I'm looking for. Oh, I've not clicked on the trees. Whoa. Oh, the trees are fake. Nice. Oh, nice. Cheap enchantment. That's what I'm looking for, too. All right, let's just go Moonsnare Specialist, bounce your Ronin. It's not, like, the best in the world, but next turn, if I draw a black, I can play these in the same turn. I mean, they can equip and attack. Akis are cool. Little turtle shell goblin samurais. All right, get your rummage on. The bounce wasn't that great, but it was just... Oh, they didn't even want a rummage. Weird. What am I doing here? Let's just attack. player replication specialist. I don't have an artifact. I really want to draw an artifact for this and this. But it's fine. I'll just wait here. I will probably not be blocking here. Yeah, their hand is so perfect, they didn't want to discard a card to draw a card. All right, so it's going to ping me for one. And then next turn, their next creature gets a plus one counter. And then the turn after that's a 2-2 haste. Sure. Oh, they didn't attack first. They gave up value. Oh, look at that. That is incredibly good. Hey, Kurt Bros, what's up? Saw you watching Aspiring Spike earlier, as was I. Look at that. Oof. Replication Specialist. This card is just very good. I mean, obviously they can kill it sometimes, and then it's not going to be quite as good, but like, my experiences with it so far is if they don't kill it, it just completely dominates the game, and it's a 3-4 flyer. It's not the easiest thing in the world to kill. I just drew make four things. Why does it get to fly? Good question. Hey, Kurt Bros, welcome back to the 22-month resub arena. Okay. Your next creature has a plus one counter and could get haste with the rabbit battery, but I'm feeling pretty good about my board state here. If I draw any land, I could play this and then play the Naomi and get the samurai because I'll have artifact and enchantment. Pretty nice. Wow, they're aggro. All these brute suits and simians, swizz slings and stuff. So I guess they can crew this, put the haster on it, crew this, attack with two brute suits. But I can just, like, do some blocks. Oh, really? We're doing that? Okay. Do I watch T-Roy Cook's YouTube channel? I don't watch any YouTube videos. Okay. Well, we're definitely doing some blocking here. I think we're going to do this plus this. And I don't think I want to trade off all the rest. So let's do that. I can't tell you, Raiden. Oh, land would have been nice, but this is also kind of nice. They're going to get a 2-2. Okay, let's just... yeah. All right. I get their 2-2. So I can hit his back for... Oh, geez. Okay, I guess I'm glad I attacked, because otherwise I would be... So I'm going to take a bunch of damage this turn. I'm at 13. I'm going to take... Oh, I guess they have to crew with this. So I'm going to take 9. Then next turn, plus 1, plus 0. And then they get a 3-3 trample haste. Sure. I got to watch out a little bit for the ping here, but we'll see. Guess I wish I left one of the tokens back to block that. Okay, so it's scry 2, then draw 2. Wow, no land so far. I definitely don't want Moon Circuit Hacker. Do I want... Can I afford a Kami of Terrible Secrets? Yeah, probably. Okay, draw a card and gain a life. And if I don't draw a land, I'll play Dockside Chef. Really hoping to draw a land here? Oh, do I want to play this? I do get to gain another life. Because right now, this is going to be plus 1, plus 0. I mean, I'm not actually doing that bad. I really wish I drew a card to make them discard. Let's just play this, because this gives me life now, and it means I have an enchantment to play next turn for Naomi. I guess the Dockside Chef would also do that, but I don't think I'm blocking with Dockside Chef this turn. I have 5 blockers, they have 4 attackers, but this also needs crewing, so. And then next turn I'm going to get like a giant flyer because I haven't Draw any lands, so I can't play anything. Opponent is spending some time chilling here, though. I'm not sure what's going on with that. Well, I guess this would also be an enchantment, sure. Yeah. Mostly this gives me... I want to start draining and getting a creature soon. Yeah, I think I'm just going to wait because this will kill them pretty easily over the next few turns. Okay. They might have wanted to crew this in response, actually. So I'm basically at 5 because this thing can ping me. This doesn't do anything special. Exiles when it kills things, but whatever, who cares? They're going to unequip. Oh, cute. And then crew and then re-equip. Yeah, I like it. Smart. But I have so many cards in hand, I don't care if I have to like just block with everything here. I'm sure I can figure out decent blocks. Let's hope their last card isn't something really sick. If they have like the deal Kami's Flare or something, which I think they might have, I go to 4, but then I still have 4 blockers, I go to 3 off the sling. Yeah, should still be fine. Their attacks aren't very good against my creatures. Others doing this. Haste, Vigilance. Do this. Hey, what's up, Satla? The 14-month resub. I am also hype for these drafts. Okay, so I feel like if they didn't kill me this turn, I'm gonna win. I mean, we'll see what their last card is. I don't think it's anything. I think they're just deciding what to put the rabbit battery on. In which case, I guess I get their last card. Maybe it's. I mean, it could be like an expensive card. You know what card's messed up that you're going to lose a lot to, or a decent amount to, given it's a rare, is that deal 10 for 10 mana that has Convoke. That card's messed up. Okay, so... Behold the Unspeakable. They're at 7. I mean... Drawing this is also pretty good. Let's just Virus Beetle. Get their last card. I mean, I didn't think their last card was much. I'm just not even going to attack with this. Because I'm going to get to ambush off the real one. And then play this. And then now it's like, what are they going to do, you know? They have a 3-3 haste. I have tons of blockers. I guess this got down to a 4-4, but I'm at 9 now. They have no cards in hand to start the turn. So I believe we are doing just fine here. I mean, at best, they can get a point of damage through. Because I have good blocks all across the board here. 4-4 on 3-3, 3-4 on 3-3, 2-1 plus 1-2 plus 1-1 on 2-2, and then chump or take the 1-3. Okay. I'm just going to block all of them. Like, there's just no point in... randomly getting burned out by something. Okay. They sure can play an additional land this turn. We're really gonna just chill here? I guess we'll see. Mm-hmm. I remember when I was at 3 life. Indeed. All right. Are we up to silver? Nice. What are we at? 4-0 now? Yeah. Okay. We're getting close to another draft. Hey, Keppel, 14-month resub arena. Welcome back. All right, opponents on the play. Pretty good. Pretty good. Getting to play Beetle into Searchlight Companion, I guess. Kami of Terrible Secrets has drawn me a card and gained me a life both times I've drawn it so far. Hasn't seemed to be that difficult to have an artifact and an enchantment in play. Oh, geez. That card's good. So, basically, it's a two. It's a mana dork, but if they ever modify it, it can become a double mana dork. Pretty good. Any what Paper Magic tournaments will look like, especially in Canada? Can't say that I do. They discarded another one, and then they played a red-white land. Okay. I mean, next turn, it's probably, if assuming they don't have a blocker, ninja this in off the hacker, replay this, then next turn play one of these two. Oh, they're playing a shrine deck or something, because now they get to make a 1-1 every turn. And they played an island. Yeah, they're definitely playing some sort of shrine deck. Okay, I get my card. And then let's just replay this, I think. These spirits are funny, though. They're not artifacts or enchantments. They're just dorks. Oh, they can make a platinum angel. Sure. Okay. So I could play this. I think I kind of just want to play this sooner rather than later. Because I'm not going to get down to one card too easily. Because getting down to draw the four off this, you have to have had zero cards in your hand at the start of the turn. I can bounce an enchantment. Sure. I mean, I think the rule is if you find a bunch of shrines, you have to draft a bunch of shrines. But don't want that. I'll probably do want another Moon Circuit Hacker. I kind of don't actually. I feel like maybe I did to bounce this thing. I don't know. Let's play this. Though I guess I can just bounce this. Bounce with the Muktai Ambusher instead. At some point, this, you know, I have to kill this or with the thing on it, but I'm just not in a real big hurry. Basically, the way this is going to play out most of the time is you'll get them to negatives and then just kill whatever's wearing this and win the game right then. Okay, now I wish I just kept the Moon Circuit Hacker. Okay. I don't want a ninja with that. I don't really want a soul transfer right now. I mean, I'm going to play the Leech Gauntlet. I think I just go Leech Gauntlet attached to this thing. I'll play a tap land. I'll name white. Hit them. Just no random reaches, right? I think it's worth playing the land, even though it makes Vision of the Unspeakable a little smaller, because it'll still be big enough to get through here. You're watching old Pro Tour streams and getting sad. Yeah, that's what happened if I watched a PT stream. All right, I got my rat. My Menace Rat. Stack with this. Hold on. You're tapping terribly. Oh. replaying Behold the Unspeakable is an unspeakable amount of damage. Oh, I guess I would have gotten one more damage in to do it post-damage. Yeah, sure, sure. That's better. Silver Fur Master. Bottom. Okay. You know things are going well if you start to count the cards in your deck before playing a draw spiral. Take action. Discard a land. Let's see. So the ninja that deals the damage. So let's put this on this thing. Oh, it tapped my mana badly again. Dang. I don't really even have great attacks, though, so let's just chill. I have Soul Transfer to... Oh, they have the Mill Shrine? Oh, I'm going to have to kill that one instead, actually. Whatever, I should be fine. Also, if they mill a creature, I can just get it back with Soul Transfer. So I kind of want them to mill the Legendary. Okay. So if I kill that, what attacks do I have? 2-3 Flying Blocker. And I can get back Replication Specialist, which I'm happy about that. The problem is attacking on the ground doesn't really accomplish a whole lot. I guess attacking with the Sky Swimmer Koi is good. So let's go both... And then I could try to do some getting of them where I think it's worth attacking with this at this point. I don't want to attack with the Leech Golem. I guess I'll attack with everything else. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get to Ninja in a Silver Fur Master. And I think, yeah, like that is going to make this block like just destroy them. Actually, this might just be... The reason I attacked with the 1-1 flyer is I really need to make sure at least one thing gets through, because they might have just chumped there. This board state's going to clear up pretty fast here. Pretty fast. Yeah, sure, whatever. Let's go. And I don't really want to put anything else in right now. Let's just say okay. Boom. All their stuff goes away, and then we just play this. And now they're extremely dead. Boom goes the dynamite. Silver Fur Master as a combat trick is pretty gnarly sometimes. So far, I've been impressed with how these games have played out. Mostly with the result of them, to be honest. No. I don't know. There's a lot of cool tricks and things are happening and card types matter and there's play. I had removal for the Platinum Angel in my deck. I would have been able to... I had a couple ways left to kill it. I'm not too worried. Okay. I want to draw an artifact here in the first couple turns. That's an artifact already. All right, there we go. To make it so this is on, plus this goes nicely. I also had the bounce spell. I can just get them to negatives, then bounce whatever's on it. Yeah. Ooh, scry two, gain two, and then 2/2 first strike. Not bad. All right, I'm just going to play this. The reason I'm just playing this is because I want to just play this on curve at 4 and have an enchantment in play. Also, there is a chance that if they don't have a blocker, I get to hit them. Yeah, I mean, well, we'll see. They get to play 2 lands this turn. Oh, no, I'm just going to get to hit them. It's just a loot, but that's still nice. I am enjoying Kamigawa so far pretty well. I guess it's just going to be the land, isn't it? Land and... Mend those circuits. Bzzzt. Okay, so now they get a 2-2 first striker. And they gain 3, and then next turn this is going to do something. Sure. I don't know if this format's slow or fast. My guess is you don't want to be too slow out the gates. They didn't play a land or do anything. Let's attack with the Circuit Mender here. If this was my only artifact, I might play the Kami first. But given the situation, I think I could attack. And if this dies, I'll just play this, you know. Oh, really? We're going to use a combat trick to beat up on a Circuit Mender? Okay, sure. Plains would be a pretty nice draw here because I've got everything in line for Naomi. They have something. They have a fight spell or something. Oh, they're going to fight the Moon Circuit Hacker. All right. I'm okay. Hey, what up, rah, 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 random hero? Oh, they're going to kill that? I think they could have just killed that and denied me a card. This seems a lot stronger. 57 months. You get a fire drill at work. Oh, there we go. The new sagas don't seem too slow. They seem pretty good. Okay, can you hit me in the air for 4 here? Sure. Land would be nice. That's unfortunate. 3-3 first strike. 3-3 untap. That's going to be a 2-4. I could get back. I could soul transfer and get back the Kami of Terrible Secrets. Could just play the Sky Swimmer Koi, but then they just pump this and I just take a bunch of damage. Actually, you know what? Let's do this. Let's exile that. Get back the Kami. And then we're going to attack with Moon Circuit Hacker. I'm not going to ninja. I just want to draw because I want to hit a land. Oh, nice. Now I have to discard. It might just be discarding the Moon Circuit Hacker, honestly. No, but then I can just play that this turn. So maybe I don't want to do that. I could discard Naomi. I don't really want to discard Behold the Unspeakable. Let's discard. Actually, let's just discard Sky Swimmer. I don't think I should have supposed to discard Temeshi. No, I'm going to discard Sky Swimmer Koi. Play a land. I'm just going to cast this. Just want to spend my mana. I think given the situation, I don't think I'm going to cast this anytime soon. Because, I mean, I'm probably going to cast either of those first. At which point, I should just keep my two powerful white cards. Because at some point, I'll get to use them. I'm at 19 still. Also, like, I don't really care if I get hit for 4 here. They don't have very many cards here. So this gets back 2 drops. But creature or vehicle. So, yeah, they're not too close to getting to use that. They don't have any blockers here either. They're going to make a 2-4, but it doesn't have haste or anything. All right. All right. Maybe I discard Naomi Pillar of Order at this point. Because this seems kind of nice to get to do this. Spinning Wheel Kick, yeah. And then I'll just play this, draw a card and gain a life. Ooh, Silver for a Master. That could be really nice. So I get a 2-4 flyer, sure. 2 cards. Commune with some spirits, huh? 4-0? I'm about to be 5-0. This game is over. Okay, this game's not over, but I am going to win it. I believe that is true. Next turn, I could just maybe Slay the Silver Fur Master. That was a good Virus Beetle, by the way. Harmonious Emergence, what is this? Oh, that land. Someone was like, you guys really underrated. This land's a B. This card's like a B. It's like, no, this card's just not that good. Three first strike. I mean, already Moonsnare Specialist dunks on this. Really badly. So let's go. And pass the turn. And then I'll just throw the Ninja Star at the Hand of Enlightenment, probably end of turn. They don't have any targets right now for this. Yeah, they're super dead. How fondly do I remember the original Kamigawa block? Pretty fondly. That was, not only was that a block I personally enjoyed, it was the first Pro Tour I ever did well was Kamigawa block draft. That was right when I was like really getting into Magic, like super heavily. It's kind of like the first year, or it was a year before the first year I played on the Pro Tour. Like, where I played some of the Pro Tours, not all of them. I don't know. I have a lot of fond memories about that. Sway the Stars, that was the PT that me and Cheon met, too. That was the PT where also me and Cedric met across the table as I money drafted and took all his money. Hey, LT, thanks for the raid, Lord Tupperware. Oh, we got to get our showdown figured out, huh? Unless you've solved the format already. Welcome, welcome. Thanks for hanging up. Or hanging out. Yeah, new format day. Stoked. I'm on the play. This is what new formats look like. You might not like it, but this is what peak performance looks like. let's play Tranquil Cove first. Though I guess I'm just going to play this on black, so maybe I should have just played that first in case I drew a black 2-drop. Oh, Oni Cult Anvil is really good. No problem, Silent Tact. Spirited Companion, that one's nice. I don't love doing this like this early, but I'm just going to cast this because I have nothing else to cast. And at some point I'll be able to soul transfer it back, hopefully. Jukai Naturalist. Oh yeah. Oh, into, look at that. Into a spirit. Look at this curve. Amazing. Okay. I'm just going to cast this. And then I'm going to cast the Samurai. And then they'll be good. Oh, that's pretty good. They get to go get two lands. And then they get to make a XX at some point here. Well, I also get to do my thing. Because now I've got enchantment and an artifact. So I can play Naomi Pillar of Order. I have three actual cards that care about this in hand. I'm going to get... Chapter 2 on this is basically a blank. I like the art on this a lot. The pixelated stuff looks pretty good. And then, oh yes, love to see the arrest on this. It doesn't, all I cared about was this being a creature, so, or an enchantment, so. I think I just trade for those two, because then next turn I can just get the Muktai Ambusher back if I want. Okay, they have a 3-3 and a 5-5 currently. At some point I'll also just soul transfer. Okay. That's fine. I don't want to do this. I don't have an artifact in play right now, so I guess I can't. I don't want a soul transfer without that. I'm at 18. They're at 24. They're going to get a 2-4 next turn. I haven't going to miss a land drop, so let's just do this. This actually generates mana for me, which is funny, because now I can do this and do this. Yeah, this is fine. I mean, a 3-2 lifelinker is pretty good. And then, again, these are on. Splashing seems pretty easy, Ghost of Dak Faden. I mean, so far, I'm splashing, and it's not been problematic. Yeah, let's just take it. I have a lot of life points to play with here. Nice. Okay. Now they have five in the air. That's a little bit more annoying. It's kind of awkward that soul transfer isn't going to get my thing back. Maybe this is kind of weird, but what if I exile? How bad is it if I exile the moth and then attack with the Mokuta Ambusher? And then play a Circuit Mender. Yeah, that actually doesn't seem too bad. Sure. Not gonna attack with Temeshi though. This is my first draft, so I have yet to draft the aggro red artifact deck. Because this gained me a lot of life this turn and removed a flyer and then put an artifact in my graveyard for Temeshi and then two on top. I don't like that. Oh, the recovery unit to get back the Spirited Companions. That's also annoying. And if they want to attack beside you into my thing, yeah, it just didn't seem like the thing they were going to do. Oh, okay. Let's do this. Get their last card. Nice. That's good. I could get back the rat here. I think it's probably better just to play this. No reason to miss land drops yet. And then I can't attack into the 7/7. Yeah. I mean, I feel like this is... If they don't have a removal for Temeshi, it's going to kind of dominate this game. Okay, they make three samurais. Not a big deal. Because it... Three on top. So they're... The best card of their top two was make three samurais, and they left three on top here. Okay, maybe they think this game's going to play out differently than I do, but we'll see. Sure. Draw a card off that. That just puts more... Let's get Circuit Mender back. Bouncing. Land. Draw. Draw, gain two, and then let's go, yeah, let's play this. They're not really going to mill me to death, though, I don't think. Pretty ambitious putting a rest on this instead of Temeshi. Like, did they think I was never going to be able to activate it? I even have the white mana in play. We'll see. We'll see what their Scry 3 on top plan involves. Because if they had a way to kill Temeshi, I feel like they would have done it last turn. Let's just take it. Oh, there we go. They probably didn't see exactly what it was doing. Yes, I agree with that, Kelsey. I mean, I have a lot of ways to try to win this game, I guess. This is a 7/7. I don't really have, like... Too much. Is it the Flash Planeswalker? No, the thing is, they kept two on top as this is the first one. I feel like they would have kept a better card. Yeah, I don't think that's what it is. I mean, it could be, but... I'm going to draw a card. I'm going to get back the Virus Beetle. Bouncing a land. Draw a card. Make them discard. Vanishing Slash. Okay. And then play this. Equip onto Samurai, I guess, whatever. Play this so I can activate it. And does it have reach? It has reach. That's why we check. They kept that up. Their bar for keeping things on top is a little lower than mine, I would say. Two more on top. Yep. Yeah, because now I'm just going to let them attack with this and then throw the Kunai at it. And now the game just ends, right? Like, very quickly here. Let's put this on the Searchlight Companion, actually. Yeah, that sounds fine. Get this Branch of Beside You out of here. Ninjutsu, because now the Twisted Embrace is in the graveyard and I can bring it back with Tameshi. And now I don't even really want to use Tameshi this turn. I don't think I'm just going to play the untapped land because I might use Dockside Chef, but I don't really want to bounce lands right now. Don't really need to. Ooh, so they really want to get back a Spirited Companion, maybe? Sure. That makes sense. Boom, boom. This is my first draft, and I'm synergying it up for sure. I just like all the options I have. It's pretty fun. Ooh, sack this to draw a card. Sure. I mean, their board is not even particularly good, but let's go X equals 4. Let's get back Twisted Embrace. Attach it to the Ambusher. Kill their first striker. Oh man, and then I have a Silver Fur Master as well. Yes, let's hit with this, hit with this, hit with this. Let's hit with everything but the Dockside Chef. Block there, Samurai. Okay, and they don't block the Ambusher. Yeah, that's kind of what I thought they would do. Return the Virus Beetle. Might as well make them discard, you know? We haven't gotten enough value yet. So make it so my ninja survives the fight. Yeah, my opponent's diamond. Also, if I was playing in silver, all the cards they played are fine, you know? I don't know. So that's a... Whoa! Brilliant Restoration. They got all their artifacts or enchantments back? Nice. Okay, that's sick. That's cool. I don't think it's going to be enough, but that is pretty cool. They get to draw two cards. They get Beside You, Enlightenment. Yeah, I like it. There are 10 cards left. I'm at 12. I guess I should make sure I don't get decked. Not that I think I'm going to. I've got some big flyers in my deck. But at this point, I guess I don't really have a good... Yes, it does make more sense that why they topped a bunch of enchantments that didn't seem that impressive yet, for sure. Mm-hmm. Okay. They can put a land on top of their deck. I don't think they're going to do that, though. Oh, no, they put the roadside shrine back. Very cute. Very cute. So I do kind of want to not draw another extra card here. Them getting back, you know, seven cards with it. Destroy up to one. What are they targeting? Oh, the Leech Gauntlet? Sure. Okay. You may draw a card. Nice. Let's play Skies from McCoy. And no real point in attacking. Let's just chill. So right now I'm going to deck them by one card. So I do have to kind of watch out. They're going to sack this, I assume. So that one of the things that kind of comes up is if you're already going to get decked, you might as well, like, them making that go faster doesn't really change much. I could attack with the Sky Swimmer. No, they have a reach 10-10, so let's not do that. They were done? After their big finish? I guess they were probably going to get decked there. So, to be fair, Matt, that's the first game of mine that has happened, because they cast a 7-mana sorcery that brings back all their artifacts or enchantments. Oh, 7 wins. Deece. And brought back 10 things, but yes. All right, that was a sick first draft and clean 7-0 sweep with Esper Artifact Ninja Enchantment value. For more drafts like this, check out Channel Fireball. This draft was sponsored by Ultimate Guard, sponsor of Team CFB. Let's hop back in the queue, shall we?